We're back with Jason Capko, senior of the St. Vincent Bearcats. Jason, thanks so much for joining us. And senior day here at the Carey Center, and you're obviously one of those seniors. What's senior day mean to you and the emotions that you'll kind of go through today?
It means a lot. It's definitely going to be bittersweet. We're obviously looking forward to it's going to be a big game against Westminster, but you know, this being, you know, my senior night and me being a senior in college, playing 4 years of college basketball, and basketball really being, you know, one of the biggest factors in my entire life, it's definitely going to be emotional whenever the time comes. So
now, with today being senior day, just recently this week, St. Vincent coming off a nice win against the Thomas More Saints. Thomas More still very likely to be the number one seed in the upcoming PAC tournament, but what's a win like that mean for St. Vincent in terms of momentum going toward the PAC tournament?
That win was huge for us because, you know, you always want to be playing your best basketball at this time of the year. And I think we did a great job of coming out and matching up with that man-to-man. I think that was the biggest difference between our game last time and our game this time was the fact that we played man-to-man defense instead of a zone. I think it helped us just play with a lot more energy, a lot more intensity, and yeah, like you said, that win was huge for us. Helps us get some momentum, and hopefully we can continue that into senior night against Westminster.
This St. Vincent team, a nice blend of youth and experience. You're obviously part of that experience factor as a senior. Give us some insight to the senior class and how you guys lead. I'm sure each one leads in different ways.
Yeah, I mean, this year was so much different than last year because last year we had so many new guys coming together. It really took us some time to gel, but I think this year, having last season under our belt already, really allowed us to, you know, come into this season with a head of steam already. We're all comfortable with the system, comfortable playing with each other, and yeah, I think we have a great senior class. I've really enjoyed playing with Matt D'Amico, Dieter, as well as Coy. I think we've brought some strong leadership, and that experience of us all playing together in the tournament last year, I think it'll really help us this year.
A lot of injuries, unfortunately, this season, but the team developed that next man up attitude, whether it was some of the youngsters that were forced to play a more significant role early. Describe that attitude, that next man up philosophy that the team's had this year.
Yeah, I mean, that was huge for us. Earlier on in the year, we had a stretch of, you know, four games where we had four of our key guys out. So, you know, we went into Bethany when we played them the first time with, you know, 7-8 guys or so who some of the guys didn't normally get the minutes that they were forced to play there. So it really helped some guys to step up. And now that we have our normal lineup back and no injuries, knock on wood, it really helps everyone because we can play, you know, a 10, 11-man rotation because we have so many guys who've gotten experience throughout the year. So at this point, now that everyone's healthy, I think that actually helped us at this point in the season.
D.P. Harris in the past has talked with me about you and your ability to drive to the basket. And obviously you have a great jump shot, but he prefers you kind of driving in with a dribble drive, setting up other guys. Talk about some of the things that you have worked on in your own game in that aspect.
Yeah, I mean, as the season went on, I definitely started to look to be more aggressive getting to the hoop. I think I had a tendency to settle for the jumper outside too much. Sometimes I had too much confidence in that. But yeah, definitely as the season went on, that's something DP has always stressed to me, to try and attack and get to the rim first, look for my jump shot second. So yeah, that's something I've tried to work on and develop throughout the year.
And you transferred from CalU Division II to St. Vincent. What led to your transferring over?
Honestly, basketball really wasn't a huge part of it. I felt like I wanted a greater challenge academically. Basketball kind of was on the back burner at that point. I think when I came out of high school and I was searching for a college, basketball was, you know, my number one priority that I was looking for there. But after I finished out my sophomore year, I kind of realized that, you know, the academics needed to be kind of more my main focus in order to prepare me for after I graduate. And St. Vincent, they have a great business school here, and things just worked out both on the court and off the court here.
Last season in the PAC championship game, you had offensively one of your best career games, 20-point night. However, Thomas More came away with the win here at the Carey Center. How much has that game served as a motivation for both you and your teammates this season?
Oh, it's a lot of motivation. Yeah, it absolutely helped to motivate us. You know, that was, I think, tough for all of us as players and a coaching staff to lose that championship here at our own court. And yeah, absolutely, through the off season, through this season so far, definitely served as a lot of motivation for us.
And as a senior, talk about what is your major and what you hope to do in the future.
I'm a business management major, and right now I'm on schedule to graduate in the spring, and I hope to work locally in Pittsburgh for a few years, get some experience, and then after that I wouldn't mind moving somewhere a little more warm than Pittsburgh for a little while.
Can't blame you for that.
Yeah.
That's senior Jason Capko on senior day here at the Carey Center. Thanks so much.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. I appreciate it.
We'll have more coming up in a moment.